What up? It's the Trooper, and welcome back to Laundry Day Q&A. All right, so I'm gonna start on Facebook, and I see the one I gotta answer right away, right off the bat. Danita. Danita says, what is the scar on your left cheek under your eye from? And when is my next honorable mention? Well, first of all, this is your honorable mention. First question, are you kidding me? This is not a scar. I'm gonna tell you right now, a lot of people think this is a scar. What, should I tell you the truth? Or should I tell you I got cut when I was like, you know, defending the honor of somebody in a CD bar somewhere, and they were hassling this chick, and I was like, hey, leave the lady alone. And they were like, and I was like, you know, and whipped their ass, except I got a little cut right here. But this is not a scar. I'm gonna tell you the truth, this is not a scar. This is just like a, I don't know what the fuck it is. It's just like a line that is usually there when I wake up, and I've only been awake for an hour. So it's there right now, but if you pay attention to the vlogs, and I could be wrong about this. First of all, I will tell you this. When I'm in better shape, it's not there. It's not as pronounced because my face is not as fat. I said it. But if you pay attention to the vlogs, I think you'll notice that it goes away later in the day. You know what I'm talking about? I don't know what I'm talking about, but that's what I think. Since we started with the ladies, we might as well continue with the ladies. Kelsey wants to know if I come there next week, we gonna kick it? You gotta show me around too. How can I say no, Kelsey? How can I say no? Yo, now that we answered a couple of the ladies, listen, there's a lot of questions. You know there's zero chance I can answer all these questions, right? No way. Yo, James Woods just pulled up on my right. Check it. Yo, Mr. Woods, James, Jimmy, what's up? I hate to go all paparazzi on you, but I'm not trying to jump out and bug you, you know what I'm saying? You know it's James Woods, right? You know who James Woods is, right? The actor, he was in Casino. He was the sleazy ass ex-boyfriend of Sharon Stone. My favorite movie that he was in was The Getaway with Alec Baldwin and Kim Basinger. He was a villain in that shit. I played with him at his table last year. You know he's in town for the WSOP. He plays poker. I don't know if you guys know that, but he plays poker. He doesn't even act anymore. He told me he was retired. I played at his table last year. Yo, let me calm down. It's just James Woods. You know what I'm saying? It's not like it's Bruce Dickinson or somebody. Kathy wants to know, how long to plan to, check your grammar, Kathy. How long, I'm gonna paraphrase, how long do you plan to live in Vegas? The hell is this dude doing? I plan to live here as long as it takes. How money do you spend on coffee? I don't spend that much money on coffee. This is like $2 and change. If I stay there, I get a free refill. I may get another coffee later today, but when I go edit the vlog, I spend like $2.36 or $2.27. And then I never spend another penny on coffee the entire time I'm there for 3 hours. But then later in the day, I might get one at the casino, which I usually use comps for. I don't spend that much. I gotta admit, I'm not putting a lot of thought into choosing these questions. I'm just sort of randomly selecting them. I don't have a lot of time today. Maybe next time I'll select questions that I really wanna answer. Where are the biggest cash games of No Limit Hold'em? If you mean in Vegas, Aria and Bellagio. Sometimes Golden Nugget can get a huge game. But if you mean in the world, I'd probably have to say California, but I don't really know for sure. LA? I mean, I don't know. They got some big games in Florida too, so. What the fuck? Excuse my language. Scott wants to know, am I still utilizing stop loss limits in cash games? I don't remember ever utilizing stop loss limits. I remember one time for a period of about 1 day or 2 days, that I was going to try to do that, but it doesn't make any sense, and I'm just not, no. No stop losses. James Woods, there he goes. All right, stop. Enough James Woods. He liked my hat last year. I was wearing my hat. This is villain on it. And he took out his earbuds to comment to me and tell me that he really loves the hat and he got it. He understood what it meant. Oh, shit. David Henson, what's up, brother? You still sing I Saw the Light. First of all, David, you sang I Saw the Light. I don't think I sang it. And second of all, there is no way in hell I'm telling these people what that means. Yo, David, what's up? Seriously, David Henson is a friend of mine all the way from second grade. You know how long ago that is? Second grade. I mean, this shit is crazy. This shit is crazy. What's up, David? I might need you to do my taxes. Who else? What else we got? Let me find some more questions here. All right, Royal G wants to know, what is your 5-year plan? Do you plan on being in Vegas, married, children, question mark? How are you? I think you meant how old are you. I am timeless, okay? Timeless. 5-year plan? My plan is for shit to change so dramatically over the next 5 years that it's gonna be a little bit impossible for me to make a plan for that. Yannick wants to know, is dealing poker helping you reading hands and recognizing betting patterns? Not anymore. When I was dealing a little bit, it always helps to watch people. But it's not about betting patterns. It's more about mannerisms and behaviors. It could have a little something to do with betting patterns from time to time. The betting patterns that I notice are pretty obvious, but right now, dealing poker is just burning me the F out. Here's a good question, Ben Davidson. What's up, Ben? I played poker with Ben quite a few times back in G Vegas. Ben wants to know why I never talk about the happenings at the link when I'm dealing. Basically, when you work for a big company, you sign a fucking thing that says, you know, social media shit. I don't know what it's called, but it's basically saying that I won't talk about or post pictures of customers or fellow employees without their permission. I just take it all the way to the limit and I don't talk about things that happen at the link. A lot of people who come in the link watch my videos. I'm talking about people that live here. People that work at the link watch my videos. Even people that I don't know who work in the pits and stuff watch my videos. So it's best that I don't. I mean, listen, if I got fired tomorrow, would it be the end of the world? Would it be a blessing in disguise? I don't know the answer to that. But I will say this, I have no intention of getting fired from the link. So, you know, it just recently happened not too long ago. Somebody posted something on Facebook about a fellow employee at a Caesars casino and got fired. You know what I mean? So I don't want to be like, yo, this little dude did this and did that and how fucking crazy it was and blah, blah, blah. And then somebody sees it and somebody tells somebody and next thing you know, I'm fired and I can't work for Caesars ever again. So that kind of sucks and I don't want to do that. There goes James Woods again. Should I get him in the vlog? Should I go, yo, Mr. Woods? He's driving a light blue Mini Cooper and he damn near just hit my car. Lance wants to know, you going to the Opeth concert in October. What? Opeth? Where Opeth going to be at? Yes. The answer is yes. Opeth is number two to Iron Maiden. Opeth is number two. Most of you people don't know who Opeth is or what Opeth is. Trust me when I tell you this. You got to listen to the whole song. You got to give it a chance. But go look up Opeth Bleak on YouTube. Listen to that shit. Ah, Jason wants to know what music do I listen to when I play poker. I listen to music like earbuds less and less these days. Sometimes it's mandatory because of just ridiculous activity or loud fucking voices or sometimes other things. Sometimes at Planet Hollywood, there's slot machines touching distance from the poker tables and they're super loud and then there'll be like four like MILFs, you know, on some kind of weird Vegas vacation and they're screaming at the top of their lungs when they hit $12. Literally, it was $28 the other day. It was 2,830 pennies, all right? And they were screaming like mad women. So, but when I do listen to music, I always, almost always listen to like electronic music. Like, I have one Pandora channel, District 78 and I listen to that. Or I listen to stuff a little more mellow, like I'll listen to Ronald Jinkies. Like I'll make a Pandora station, you know, for Ronald Jinkies. There's one for Claypex that I used to listen to all the time. By the way, we moved over to Twitter now. David wants to know, if I were to do it all over again from the start, what would you do differently? Well, I don't remember much from like ages 1 to 5. After that, there's a shit ton that I would do differently, but I think you mean since I moved to Vegas. I don't think I would do very much differently since I moved to Vegas, because since I moved to Vegas, I've like learned a lot, mostly about myself, but I wish I could go back, you know, quite a few years, but and realize that I was being so lazy. Nash wants to know how many of the casinos in Vegas I've been to. Most of them? Most of the big ones. Not little ones like Jerry's Nugget, although I've been to Jerry's Nugget a long time ago. Melanie wants to know, we all live our Vegas dreams through you, but do you ever get sick of tourists? Sick doesn't begin to describe it. But how can you be mad at tourists? Because tourists make Vegas what it is. And they also make the poker games. I do not get tired of tourists at the poker tables, ever, 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 ever. But I do get tired of them walking around and stopping and walking on the left and stopping in front of me. And, you know, there's like 1,000 things I could mention that they do that is aggravating as hell. Mike wants to know, my biggest pet peeve about people when playing and when dealing. My goodness, man, biggest pet peeve. I do have a few pet peeves. Rookie mistakes are not really a pet peeve. Like, you know, people that say raise when they make a bet or something like that. I think one pet peeve of mine, it's really a dealer pet peeve, but as a player, I see it all the time. Asking the dealer for 20 whites or something, you know, stopping the dealer or slowing the dealer down from dealing the game to do anything is a complete pain in everyone's ass. And when you're sitting there with 2 stacks of red and you see that you're gonna be in the big blind next hand and you throw $20 to the dealer and ask for 20 whites, don't do that. Just don't do it. Please don't do it. It probably aggravates me more as a player than as a dealer, because as a dealer, I just ignore it until I just keep pitching the cards. And then when I have a free minute, yes, I will give them 20 whites. Sometimes I'll say, I don't have that many to give you, and I'll give them 10. But you don't need white chips. Put a red chip out for your, if you need it for a cocktail waitress, that's completely different. You throw one nickel in and you ask for change, that's completely different. I'm more than happy to accommodate that request because it's something that you actually need. Getting change otherwise is just completely retarded. Here's another one I hate. Okay, here's one that I hate, and it's another dealer pet peeve, but I hate it from the player's chair, and that is when you have a stack of fucking whites and the bet is $2 and you call by throwing in a red chip. Having dealers make unnecessary change is a huge pet peeve. Don't do it. Just don't do it. Timothy asks if I play any other table games or slots. No. Never. I hope I answered your questions. I know I can't get to all the questions. Thanks for asking them though. And we're gonna do this more often. We're gonna do it again. And yeah, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about my videos and leave a comment below. And I'll see you next time.